Hi, I'm Liz.
And I'm Fiona. We're here to show you the barge. The barge is where alliances can score algae and robots can climb at the end of the match.
The barge is made out of truss and spans the center of the field. It includes 6 cages and 2 nets and has a red side and a blue side.
The cages are located approximately a quarter, a half, and 3/4 of the distance between the edge and the center of the field. Make sure to check the game manual for specific dimensions.
Before the match begins, teams are able to select if the cage associated with their driver station will be a shallow cage or a deep cage. Teams must alert the field staff during field reset if they want the height of the cage adjusted, as the default is to leave them in the same state from the last match.
When climbing, teams should be aware that they can't touch the top of the cage, chain, or accompanying hardware. Pay close attention to the game manual on what a legal climb is.
Oh, good point. Climbing on the deep cage might not be as easy as it seems.
That's right. Teams should be mindful of the cage dynamics, especially when they swing, as they design their robot to get their center of gravity and packaging right. It may be a little tricky.
These cages are a real challenge. Let's look at what happens when robots interact with them and how much they swing.
Good idea. First, let's look at the shallow cage. Shallow cages are approximately 2.5 feet off the ground and are intended to be a height where some robots can drive right underneath them if they choose. Teams will have to look closely at the exact dimensions if they want to design their robot to be able to fit underneath these.
If a robot does hit this as they are coming through, it will move around and swing. So teams should be prepared to handle this if they want to climb.
Now we'll show a deep cage. Deep cages are only a few inches off the ground and are attached to the barge with a chain. Robots are not going to be able to fit under this one.
If a robot hits this cage, it is going to move around much more than the shallow cage, though it may be worth the challenge. Deep cages are worth more points if your team can figure out how to get off the ground while using this cage.
The other thing teams should be aware of is that once a cage is hit and swinging around, they can continue moving for a while.
Teams should be careful as they navigate the barge to avoid damaging their robot or an alliance partner's robot.
From your own side of the field, robots should be able to see 2 April tags on the barge, one centered on your net and one on the opponent's. They're angled down to help make it easier for teams to see them. See the field layout and markings diagram for exact dimensions and details.
The barge also contains the nets, which is where the human players and robots can score algae. Each alliance has a net and earns additional points for the total number of algae scored throughout the match.
Robots can score algae directly into the net once they are acquired. Be sure to watch the REEF video for more details.
Human players can score algae if an opposing alliance's robot passes them an algae through the processor. Be sure to watch the processor video for more info.
Alliances will want to work together and use the processors, because if each alliance uses it 2 times, both alliances achieve coopertition. The barge will light up to show progress towards an achievement of coopertition.
Good luck, and we'll see you at the competition.
Behat slacha venire etim bata charut.